privilege to deliver this memorial lecture in the name of Mangal Singh Memorial Lecture. And I thank STAI giving honor to this deliver the lecture, because Mangal Singh is a high technocrat, and I was closely associated with him in my earlier days. When we and JPMA and Agrima, when he was in Agrima, he jointly did the work in Sudan. So at that time I had a very close contact with him, and I respect Mr. Mangal Singh's his knowledge and his way of working, his way of his management, etc. And one thing I would like to tell about Mangal Singh, he is a very good trainer. He, wherever he goes, his subordinates, juniors, everybody, he trains in very nice manner. One of his policies is he take you and drop in the middle of the sea. If you are efficient enough, you will swim and come back to the shore. And if you are not efficient, you will drown there itself. So that such a person he doesn't want. So this is a way he policy. And they trained many people, even I think it's not known this one. And I learned from that actually. So wherever we go, we have to develop ourselves, we have to learn ourselves, and we have to fulfill the requirement of our bosses. And in that way, I respect Mr. Mangal Singh. I feel privileged to deliver this lecture on behalf of you. This is the topic selected by me is the integrated project model with advanced technological options. In this one, we are normally doing many things in our industry, but I like to have a different way of doing it. We have the viability of the sugar plants in the current scenario is a question mark for all of us. This is a common subject for everybody. Reduction in KVL and increase in raw material and production costs, lower revenue from byproducts. And ours is an integrated sugar complex, sugar, cogeneration and ethanol. And we have to make advanced technology options for our sustainability. So the topics which is covered by me in this one, not a regular recommendation topic, a slightly different deviation from our normal route. So I have covered here a sugar, whether you have to produce a plantation wheat sugar or a refined sugar. This comparison has been given here. And whether we can have an alternative production of sugar sweetener, which is jaggery, whether we can have a joint production of sugar plus jaggery. Of course, cogeneration is one of our heart of this one. Then, what are the alternative use of bagasse, which cover one of the important is the cellulosic ethanol production. And the third one is the other one is the cane development, which is also an important one. And the last one is the CAPEX and OPEX monitoring. This is, though it's not a technological one, but as a manager, it is a very important important part which every manager has to go through that. So the sugar from sugarcane, we produce a plantation wheat sugar or a raw sugar, which is followed by refined sugar. Now, in the normal, any whether you produce a plantation wheat sugar or refined sugar, the losses has to be controlled actually. So we have known losses in bagasse, bitter cake, phenol losses, but we have also unknown losses, the physical loss of sugar, chemical degradation of sugars, bacteriological contamination, and assessment and weighment errors. So these are some of the losses which need to be controlled for making our project viable. So the losses is distributed in this fashion. Major is 62% phenol losses, second is bagasse, the others are filter cake and unknown losses. Some of the factors affecting sugar losses or cane quality, and type of product you produce, either raw sugar or refined sugar or plantation of sugar, operational efficiency, control of operating parameters, type of equipment and machinery, then the sizing of equipment and its capacity and its utilization, and downtime and stoppages. The selection of equipment also very important to reduce the losses, that is, some suitable cane preparing devices to achieve higher preparation, larger diameter pressure fit loaders can be considered, optimum number of milling units, meshed loops, lotus rollers and two roller mills, the options are available in front of us, and the newly implemented the moisture control unit for reducing bagasse moisture and increase the juice extraction of the milling unit, then minimum residence time of juices in our process, then reduction of sugar losses in the filter cake, then even design of the some of the equipment with the evaporator, design vapor space, sufficient vapor space to avoid entrainments, and centrifugals with optimum spinning time. These are all the very common ones which we know all this one, but anyway, these are the contributing factors for sugar losses which we are creating. Now, I make an effort whether plantation white sugar is a profitable one or the refined sugar is a profitable one. One of the factors we have to consider, which is profitable for our sustainability. So this is the normal specification of plantation white sugar and refined sugar. One of the biggest this one is the sulfur content, because they are following the sulfurization process, whereas refined sugar is very less. So it's better to consider even refined sugar as one of the alternative. And in the EC grade white sugar, we have the standard quality producing 45 kusar. This is a good market and is having also good exportable potential. Now, the process program for the plantation white sugar is milling, followed by liming and sulfurization, clarification, evaporation, crystallization, centrifugal, and drying for producing plantation white sugar. And only making sulfurization drop, only liming we produce a raw sugar. Otherwise, all other processes are same. In the refined sugar from raw sugar, after raw sugar, we have operation, melting, clarification, filtration, crystallization, centrifuging, and making refined sugar, and with the process going for a recovery units. Now, the merits of refined sugar, R&R sugars are premium grades, GDC, EC grade 2 sugars, which is good, exportable market, you can get it, and it is sulfurless. And during manufacturing process, they are low scaling and corrosion because no sulfur, and no sulfur in molasses, which is also good for ENA production and better TP quality. And during manufacturing process, we have minimum inversion due to neutral pH we are maintaining, reduction in lime quality for raw sugar, high syrup risk compared to PWS, melt concentration using low pressure vapor. But there are some demerits also. High capex and opex due to additional capital cost, extra steam requirement, more effluent generation, additional chemical cost, and also we require skilled manpower. Now, at any basis for a 5000 TCD plant, for a plantation white sugar and a refined sugar, the expected recovery plantation is 12.21. The same thing if the refined sugar is 12.08. So, and it's having, it requires some sulfur, percent care required, and the other chemicals required, the phosphoric acid, dechlorization, propellant, sodium chloride, sodium hydroxide, hydrochloric acid. And the filter cake is 3.68 with plantation white sugar at 3.30 for refined sugar. Final was 4.23 at acid with 4.36. And we require some additional 2 kilowatt per TCA as compared to plantation white sugar. It's not only this one. In compared to plantation white sugar, we require additional power required. And we also additional require around 2% of cake. This is based on the work, case study and for actual project work done, and that comparison is being given here. Now, the operating cost of chemicals, for plantation white sugar we have only lime and sulfur, which is costing totally 0.72 lakhs in a day. But for refined sugar, we have lime, the other phosphoric acid degradation, etc., etc., and we require around 1.23 lakhs per day. You know, this is only the operating cost for the chemicals. Now, apart from chemicals, we have cane price and sugar tax, which is costing around 166.26 lakhs for plantation oil, and for refined sugar 164.49. Then, the additional steam and power, as compared to plantation oil, is zero. We require around additional 1.02. The total operating cost that way for plantation oil is 166.98, and for refined sugar is only 166.74. Even though the additional is not there, because of the cane price is slightly different because of the recovery based on FRP only. Now, the revenue and net profit we calculated from the sugar sales and filter cake and molasses, we get the revenue sales of 226.27, that is 230.32. So, we require, we make a net profit of 59.29 for plantation and refined sugar 63. Plus 4.29 lakhs per day we get even with the refined sugar. But this is based on the present pricing of the sugar and cane. So it is still worth considering to go for refined sugar in place of plantation oil sugar, which is going to be a profitable one. Now, with the present scenario of cane, sugar and molasses, refined sugar production is still profitable as compared to plantation oil sugar. Now, the next option, I am considering a dairy unit, which is annexed to its sugar plant. Why this is being considered? In some of the areas where dairy plants are, population is very high, the nearby sugar factory doesn't get the cane. The cane is getting diverted to dairy plants. But dairy consumption in Indian market is a constant consumption. Whatever you produce sugar, there are some group of people, they always consume dairy. So there is a constant market for dairy. And nowadays, the dairy process is also has been improved further. So we are, people are producing organic dairies and powdered dairies, and which is well having a good export market. Now, dairy is a pure, traditional, unrefined form of sweetener. It is a good source of minerals like calcium, iron, phosphorus and protein. And in Indian production is around 9 to 10 million tons per annum. Now, the factors considered for dairy production is sugar cane price offered by sugar mills in the threshing season, and then time of commencing the threshing operation at sugar mills, and dairy prices and its demand in the market. Now, in this result, what we have considered now, only a portion of primary juice is diverted for dairy production, and the balance dairy primary juice is converted to the normal route. The advantage is the secondary juice and the bagasse we are able to process in the sugar unit, and the bagasse the fuel, which otherwise in a normal dairy plant it is a fuel merely burnt. After taking the primary juice, the rest of the bagasse along with the secondary juice dried and burned for dairy body. So in this way, we could recover some of the energies, some sugar and some energy in the factory. Now, if for a comparative calculation purposes, we are taking a 23% of primary juice for dairy production. This is around 20% of the cane is diverted for this one. And complete secondary juice and remaining primary juice is diverted for the manufacturing sugar. And steam and power from sugar plant supplied for the agri manufacturer, and natural plant based flocculant used for clarification process, and the dairy is made in a conventional open farm value. For information, this idea was floated by our founder, Mr. J.P. Mukherji, way back in 1980 to the government, but there was no takers for that. There was just wrote it forgotten. But now, this is again being reviewed, even at various levels. Now, I made a comparison statement of for a same 5000 BCD plant working for 160 days. The equivalent cane diverted For that is around 1150 tons, okay, around 20% of this one, approximately. This is also a model workload in our one of our project work, which I am giving here for comparison purpose. So, the primary juice diversion is around 23%, which means what we get a sugar recovery in the sugar plant 11.35, if you diverted this, the sugar recovery will be around 9.43 and the jaggery recovery will be around 2.71. So, some of the when calculating the financial viability, the purchase of sugarcane considered in this calculation is 3,000 rupees per ton. Conversion cost is 7,500 rupees per ton of sugar, this cane to sugar, and molasses to alcohol is 9,000, and cogen is 32 rupees per watt. Then primary use jaggery, this is one of the attractive ones, is only 35 rupees per ton of jaggery. Because there is no other process, only boiling and slicing and molding, sorry. And then sugar selling price extract is around 35,300 rupees per ton. Power selling price is 6,200 per megawatt. Ethanol price extract is 39,000 per kiloliter. And extracted jaggery is around 33,000. This 33,000 as a country average acre in various places is very different, up to even 60,000 rupees per ton. But for this calculation purpose, I only taken 33,000 so that we have a common figure for everything. Now, in this one, if you calculate the revenues, for a sugar factory, it is around 401 crores, whereas for the jaggery plant, it is around 413 crores. And if you calculate all the expenditures, it is 350 crores for expenditure and 345 crores for jaggery plus sugar. So, here also, we get a net profit of around 17 crores per annum. So, the jaggery plant annexion is also a good option for us to improve our viability. There are some question marks are there in this project, how the excise duty will be considered, and in the present new GST formula, what are the implications? Okay, these are the other secondary thing, but anyway, the idea can be mooted and we can work out the details, and which if it is really profitable, definitely we should consider this option. Next is the cogeneration. In the cogeneration, the first sugar mill in India, the most of the movements started in 1930s. But only 1992, the National Program on Promotion of Bagasse Waste Cogeneration was mooted in India. In 1998, de-licensing of sugar mills was taken. And in 1998-99, 14 states announced power purchase policies. In 2001 and 2, power sector reforms, slow project commissioning, power sector, some reforms are taken which has slowed the project commissioning, and some states go back on purchase policies. But in 2002, MURC issues incentive tariff for the buyback of electricity from the gas. In 2003, Electricity Act was introduced. And 2006, some tariff policies were introduced. Then 2008, National Action Plan on Climatical Change, which has given some problem for us. But in 2010, the Renewable Energy Certificate Mechanism has been introduced, which has been really supported. But in 2016, there is the reluctance of ACRC for new and renewal of PPA, which is even currently doing, which is affecting our cogeneration problems. Now, in the cogeneration option, we have different boiler steam conditions, right from 21 at 320 degrees centigrade, up to 110 at 540 degrees centigrade. We have various options. Even many factories are having even gone for 125 or not. Okay. So, we have all options in front of us to work out, mostly with only bagasse as a fuel, without any other fuel. 67, 87 and 110 are more viable in terms of cost of this one, etc. But I am not going to details of all those things. In the cogeneration benefits, the technical benefits, we have better power quality and improved reliability. Optimum utilization of energy is available in the grass. And the system designed by our cogeneration is to meet the fluctuating our process steam demand. And social benefits, it is ability to use the biomass and organic matters like king grass and agro waste and even gate trashes, etc. Increased rural employment and increased access to electricity supply. The fuel is a renewable source, whereas the renewable source of energy, and this results in reduced emission levels and global warming, and therefore it is an environmental friendly one. And economical benefit, especially for the solar complex, is virtually zero fuel cost for the project complex, and improved commercial performance of solar complex, and techno-commercial viable project with short payback period. Now, in addition to this, the reduction in transmission losses because of proximity to load centers, we are closely connected to the grids, and we also have central financial assistance, fiscal incentives, concession import duty, excise duty, tax holiday for 10 years, soft loan from STF, and some states even given gain purchase tax exemption, especially in Maharashtra. So these are the benefits available. Some are applicable, some are not applicable, but whatever is applicable, it can be placed for our regulations. But you all know in the current scenario, the trend of addition of power from cogen in sugar factory is declining in the last 4-5 years. See, one of the MRI's website, this graph is available, from various states, how the powers are this one. But the gas plus cogeneration is declining in the past 4-5 years. The gas is mainly due to the gas price as well as power tariff fluctuation. There's a very huge fluctuation which is affecting our economy. And inertness of state government and SREC for special tariffs and new PPA. Though we are all going dashing and dashing, but they are not moving and they are not willing to consider our request. So that is really affecting our scenario. So the barriers which are faced by the cogeneration industry, technology wise, lack of capability to generate a bankable project on account of financial and liquidity problems, which is mainly applicable for the weaker units, and need of optimization. Of sugar fuel performance of the existing fuel mills to adopt cogeneration, and grid stabilization is also one of the technologies we have barrier. Then, in management barrier, we have weak financial management of existing facilities. Cogen for small size mills are not economical and demands for expansion, and non availability of adequate cane for the season for the certain areas. Then, in the regulatory, I do high wheeling and open access charges in some states, which is affecting our this one, and I already mentioned the power tariff rate fluctuation. Now, the market, increasing completely usage of biomass resources leading to higher opportunity costs, where the wind power and the presently solar power is completing our market trends. So, we are not able to compete with them in terms of tariff and other areas. Solar power is becoming cheaper and cheaper. So the cogeneration in the sugar industry are facing various technological, economical and regulatory barriers which is hindering the growth of cogen in the sugar industry. So the cogen projects which are viable at one stage are now faced to ponder only direct selling of the sugar. But what is the way forward? Future development in the sector is largely dependent on the promotional policy measures from government and regulatory authorities, without which we cannot move. Implementing uniform, conducive, appropriate policy and regulatory initiatives and providing economic support from various agencies in the area. And strong renewable purchase obligations compliance by power distribution companies and streamlining of REC mechanism is required to attract industries, project developers and investors to invest in renewable energy in the country. Use of alternative biomass fuel, such as cane grass, king grass, agriculture waste, energy crops, etc. are to be explored. In terms of cost of effective cultivation and also effective collection methods for replacing the installed capacity during off-season. Otherwise, we are keeping our equipment idle for more than 4 to 5 months. But with the proper tariff values, this project is still a viable project, which everybody has to tackle it and dash it with the government wherever it is necessary. But since the project is viable, only the tariff is our question mark. Now, in absence of viable cogeneration, what are the other alternatives for the bagasse? So, the bagasse is used for pulp and paper, then the particle board, particle and corrugated boards, and chemicals that secondary secondary generation of ethanol production and furfural, etc. And then some other products like charcoal, graphene, etc., plastics, animal feed, etc. Then the other one is often is bagasse gasification. Now, the bagasse usage for pulp and paper is mainly concerned the fast depleting forest resources, so it's overall a good alternative, and reduce the dependence on imported newsprint and imported pulp. So, bagasse is one of the good resources for the paper production. Now, there are sugar mills without cogeneration, they can sell the bagasse there, directly surplus bagasse to the paper industries. The other one, there are some factories which are actually sugar mill and paper mill in the same facility, so the excess bagasse is diverted for paper production. And third model is newsprint and paper mill in a remote area, and they give alternate fuel to the sugar mill to take 100% bagasse as a raw material for paper production. This model very successfully working in the world is Tamil Nadu Newsprint and Papers Limited, which is producing around 4 lakh tons per annum. They mix bagasse pulp and hardwood chemical pulp in the ratio of around 85% to 15%, and the bagasse requirement is 5 tons per ton of paper. This another mill is Mysore Paper Mill, which is having attached to the sugar factory. It is 1 lakh tons per annum producing, having sugar plants of 2500 TCD. And the third one is in a Pune Sugar Seshai Paper Mill, and around 60% of the bagasse produced from the Pune Sugar has diverted. There are still some more paper mills are in the North Indian also. So this model, diverting bagasse to the paper, is one of the sources. But still, the paper requirement, we cannot, whatever the bagasse production is, we cannot completely divert it, because still we have excess bagasse, or even after meeting this demand, unless we have exporting of the pulp, which is still again market oriented, whether this one. So still, we are left with excess bagasse, we have to find other alternatives also. So, this is a normal flowchart for paper and pulp process, and this is a normal system for particle board process. We are not going to details of these things. The second one is the second generation of ethanol production with cellulosic ethanol from bagasse. Now, lignocellulose ethanol is an emerging route for ethanol production. The feedstocks for this is bagasse, rice straw, various grain straw, etc. Sugarcane bagasse is one of the potential feedstock for lignocellulosic ethanol production. Now, this is a normal flow diagram. In the hydrolysis process, we separate sugar and other agar, and each is fermented and distilled, and ethanol is recovered, and the lignin which is coming out is again sent back to the boiler. So the fiber and the lignin is again used for this one. Now, the lab scale or pilot scale yield, as reported, is giving around 110 to 125 liters per ton of bagasse on a yearly basis. I think recently one factory in Maharashtra, they are doing this experiment with Hajj actually. But the developments are still in progress for higher yield and viable cost of it. These figures are very rough figure which is given to us, it is still not officially clear. But commercial plant is not fully established in this world so far. Everywhere it is only the pilot scale model, up to pilot scale only. There are reasons for these things, but this is the potential route of ethanol production in, for the futures to come, but economical viability definitely is to be looked into. From the indications, the estimated conversion cost of bagasse ethanol route is more than 2 to 2.5 times as compared to molasses ethanol. And also the cost of the plant is very, very high as of today. So, the cellulose ethanol route, though it is a potential route, but as of today, it is still not viable. So we have to wait and watch. Now, based on the gasification of wood chips, gasification of bagasse is also now is being developed. People are working on this one. This is also another potential route for diversification of bagasse, but again, this is also subject to economic viability. No data are still available for this option. Now the next point is cane development, which is the core issue for any sugar complex sustainability. Now, the cane development is done one for tonnage, that is yield, which again depends on expansion of area and productivity, and again the productivity is dependent on variety and production technology development. The other one is the quality, and the quality of the cane also depends on the varietal, this one, and climatical change and cultivation practices. Now, sugar recovery percent cane and cane yield is an important aspect for sustainability of the sugar industry. The recent success story of units located in subtropical regions of India are worth considering, and that is why this topic of cane development I included in my topic, because the recent development is really very much encouraging for the industry. Uttar Pradesh has become the largest sugar producer. The state is situated in the subtropical region, and very short growth period, 5 to 6 months, due to extreme climatic conditions. Also having a problem of moisture stress, poor rain management, and age of the place, crop is less in comparison to some of the states in the tropical region. But the state share during last season in total production is about 43%, a significant increase of about 22.13% compared to the previous year, a tremendous achievement. And average yield of sugar cane in 2016-17 was around 72.37 tons per hectare, as against 66.46 tons per hectare in the previous season. Now, adoption of intensive cane development program, especially in privately managed factories, is has helped in propagating this scheme. And gradual replacement of low recovery and rejected varieties, and increased proportion of early varieties, these are some of the developments done. And implementation of recommended agronomic practices, and favorable climatic conditions, because in terms of rainfall is a variable figure, every year it changes, and temperature is not those changes, but sometimes when the climatic change is there, and sunshine photoperiod, this is normally concept which is not disadvantageous, not much of affecting this one. Now, propagation of high sugar yielding varieties, which is CO0238, CO0118 and CO98014 are being propagated. The prominent variety among these is CO0238, and this variety was evolved at the Sugarcane Breeding Institute Regional Center, Karnal, and released in 2009 as an early maturing variety for commercial cultivation in northwest zone. Now, in UP, the area under CO0238 is about 35% of total area as compared to 18% last year. And in some practices, even between 80 to 98% of total bone grain thrush. Even though the early variety, no sugar deterioration was observed up to February end, but it's also having a problem of susceptible for top borer, but anyway, this is the management, you have to be careful on this. Now, better cane management is one of the steps forward, which is a good scientific approach. This is to some extent lacking in our in Indian dissemination, not all places, but many places. The soil management and fertilizer application. If you compare the management of agriculture development in other countries to India, we now soil analysis we rarely do it. Okay, but the fertilizer application should be correlated with the soil analysis. What fertilizer the soil wants, only that much is true. Otherwise, simply dumping unnecessary is a waste of energy and money. The second one is irrigation system. This system also is to be designed as for the water availability. We normally follow furrow irrigation and drip irrigation, and because of our farmings are small areas, we are not able to adopt the spray mechanism and all everything. But whatever the system we follow, and should be correlated with the water availability in that area. The third one is a proper drainage plan. If you see now in this one, we don't drain the water before harvesting, because the system itself is not available. So we are lacking in this one. Wherein when an equalized development development in other India, when the land preparation itself, they prefer land in such a way suitable for harvesting, suitable for irrigation, and suitable for drainage. So this type of planning will definitely help us to improve our grain productivity as well as recovery. Now, better control at the procurement centers, this is applicable for India. Reduction in waiting time of cane at centers as well as gate, and satellite based imaging cane survey for better planning of cane harvesting supply. This is now maybe the electronic media is coming. This definitely should help us in each factory to control the harvesting and supply. So the success stories of Uttar Pradesh and other tropical regions are to be replicated in the tropical regions also, so that whole industry in India can go forward for a profitable one. Now, almost every sugarcane growing state is having a potential for yield improvement. There exists a gap of about 6 to 24 tons per hectare between the state average yield and the Franklin demonstration yields, that is the plants which was developed by the farmland developed by under institutional supervision. There's a gap is there. Now the gap can be gradually reduced by transfer of new technology to the farmer's field, application of recommended doses of fertilizers, and proper nutrient management. I am not telling it is not followed, but still there's a scope. Now, the measures for improving the sugarcane productivity profitability is already discussed in North India Sugarcane Association. Availability of quality seed, this one of these, varietal planning and replacement of rejected varieties, and independent cane development and cane procurement mix. In the southern states, this is normally for every factory having their own cane department. It is again divided into two. One is concentrating on supply and procurement and supply, and other concentrating on cane development, which is mostly missing in the North India. So, this type of development attached to the factory, so that each factory for their own cane supply, they concentrate for a good variety with a good yield and good recovery. The improvement in the root crop management is one of the technical one for the agricultural development, and reduction in cost of cultivation. Some intercropping methods also being used to make up some of the losses. Then mechanization of sugar crop cultivation and harvesting. This is another, this one is, see, today we are facing the harvesting labor problem, so we are trying to convert for mechanical harvesting. But one thing we are not making this one is, when you consider mechanical harvesting, the land has to be prepared suitable for that. And what type of harvesting equipment you are using, depending upon even the wheel setters of the equipment and the blades height, etc., are to be considered, and the land need to be prepared to suit for this. When only you will be successful. Otherwise, unnecessarily blaming the equipment, which is, I got a harvester which is broken in 1 month or 1 week. That is not the why it is breaking. There are some other thing, features also to be considered. So, this mechanization has to be considered with the proper planning and control of insects, pests and diseases, and implementation of water saving technologies, I already told, and the other one is the contract farming. Because we are having small holdings, we are not able to maintain or control the proper management. But some areas where the contract management, say group together of many fields to one form, so that you can plan your complete activities right from soil analysis, land preparation, irrigation system, and fertilizer applications, all controlled under one roof in order to improve our yield as well as recovery and variety distribution, etc. So, this need to be considered, but still we are not successful. Some practices really tried, but you know, the farmers inventing the word, they don't want to lose it. So, but anyway, still people are working on this one. Definitely this is going to give us a good benefit and sustained effort towards improvement of sugarcane production and its productivity. Now, sugarcane research institutions like STAI Coimbatore and ISSR Lucknow are reported to be continuing their efforts in developing new high sugar and high yield varieties. As per the MOU signed between Sugarcane Breeding Institute Coimbatore and South Indian Sugar Mills Association, 20 new varieties are in the process of development and field trials are underway in 9 sugar factories of Tamil Nadu state. Now, after all this one, I am coming to a CapEx and OpEx of sugar complex. Though we are engineers and technologists, we are also managers. For a successful manager, unless you control your financial, this one, you cannot meet your ends. So, a CapEx and OpEx control is to be considered as a technology only. And you have to monitor at every stage this CapEx and OpEx. Now, what is CapEx? CapEx is a capital expenditure. It's the funds required for setting up a sugar industry, cogen plant, ethanol plant as a complex, or even an expansion, modernization, rehabilitation also. The CapEx includes expenses of plant and non-plant buildings, plant and machinery, other fixed assets, pre-operative expenses, working capital, marginal money, and pre-operative interest. Now, here I worked out some examples, which is also a project case study, worked out in 2014-15. I am giving out the main figures of this one. How this CapEx and OpEx can be helpful to you. The basis of this one is a 5,000 TCD plan, a 30 megawatt cogen with 100 KLPD cell unit, working for 160 days, and total gain price is around 8.12 lakhs. So, the cost of the project worked out with preparatory work, buildings, plant and machinery, furnitures and fixtures, light vehicles, heavy vehicles, pollution control equipment, computers, electronics, pre-operative expenses and margin money. For sugar it is 186 crores, for cogen it is 190 crores, and distillery is 149. Here the main thing is The insulation boiler and independent turbine is for production is considered under the pollution control equipment. And the total, the project is around 525 crores for a total sewer complex. Now, optimization of capex is dependent upon the selection of project site based on available resource and utilities. This is one of the important one. Otherwise, we will be increasing our cost. Organized plant layout to reduce material handling cost. Timely commissioning of the project and early starting of commercial production. This is one of very important one we want to make. Otherwise, you will be unnecessarily burdened with interest when you start not producing your product in a scheduled time. Because ours is a seasonal industry. If within the first 6 months, if you wrote this one, you have to wait for another 6 months. But what is wrong? You are going to unnecessarily make interest burden on you. Many projects went to red line because of this. So we have to monitor this one commissioning a very tight schedule, a tight program of monitoring the project monitoring is very important for starting the project and ending the project with a time frame. And technology selection, acquiring the best in class technologies to enhance the production. Then optimal design of equipment to reduce investment cost and energy saving. Complete automation of the plant is most important in the present scenario to reduce stoppages and also human errors. Our efficiency will be improved in these automations. And sourcing of funds with low rate of interest on debt. Then effective project management from concept to commissioning of the project. Now, OPEX. What is OPEX? This is the operational expenditure. The expenditure is required for the day-to-day operation of the sewer industry, cogen plant and ethanol plant. OPEX includes raw materials, fuel, salaries and wages, utilities, consumables, maintenance, repairs, administrative expenses. Operating expenses also include depreciation of plant and machinery, which are used in the production process. Now, if a sugar plant operates for a 5,000 liter plant, which is cane cost, development cost, less exercise, packing material, chemicals, stress, etc., and also finance expenses, interest on term loan bank, interest on working capital, bank charges, depreciation. So we work out around 3,639 rupees per ton of cane is required for sugar plant only. For a cogen plant, it is around 462 rupees per ton of cane is required. I'm not going to the detailed calculation. We have completely this project model is worked out and submitted for the financial institutions. So the figures are very authentic. And then for a distillery plant is around 970 rupees per ton of cane. Now, the optimization of OPEX is the raw material cost. This is up to around 70 to 80% of operating cost. And energy and utilities is around only 20 to 30%. So savings should be possible only within the margin of only 20 to 30% of operating cost. So the opportunity to operate maximum season duration is one of the important consideration for controlling OPEX. And consistency in production with minimum breakdowns also is to be considered. Then consistency in quality of end produce to attract market price. Sustained plant efficiency, reduction of losses and reduction of water and energy consumption. This also gives us a good remuneration for OPEX. And effective operating management and effective spare parts management. Then highly efficient qualified operation and maintenance staff, which also gives us help with profits. And knowledge of government subsidies on raw materials, byproducts, energy savings and utility. Sometimes we don't place the subsidies, so we are the losers. So we should have the sufficient knowledge to utilize these subsidies. And knowledge transfer, training. See, we install the factory, but the factory will continue on. People will be changing. But once you give the training to the subordinate, that fellow will take over to and he maintains the efficiency of the plant so that we get the result. And in the present scenario of co-generation, carry out the energy audit to save energy in all sections. This is also one of the important ones. So, a financial feasibility has worked out. In the case study, which is I already mentioned, is worked out in 2014-15. At that time, the cane price was only 2,800 rupees per ton, and selling price of sugar was 28,500 rupees per ton. Power at 5.72, and alcohol prices are 40,000 per ton. Though, and but the current scenario, the cane price and sugar prices are increased. Cane is 3,300 and white sugar is 36,000 and power is 6.2 and alcohol is 45,000 per liter. So with this one, the revenue earning is we get 5,832 rupees per ton of cane we can earn. As per that 2014-15 study. And operating expenditure is around 5,799. So we get a profit before tax around 758 rupees per ton of cane at that time. But in the present scenario, the same figure changes to 1,894 rupees per ton of cane, almost double. So the financial ratios we work out, whether our financial ratios or within the accepted norms, then only you are in the safe hands to earn the profit. Like debt service coverage is 1.64, which is less, maximum 1.6, it should be above 1.6. Average breaking point is less than 50%, is 39.7. IRR is 24.5, is greater than 80%. And then the payback period, in that study, with that sugar price and cane price, it was just 5, which is actually should be less than 5 years. But the same thing in the present scenario of cane prices is only 4. As same comparison, the capital cost I kept it same because there is no change of today 5 years in the plant between 2014-15 to now. Not really major change. So I kept the same, but the operating cost is changed. And so the financial issues have changed. So this has to be monitored periodically whether you are within your projected parameters so that your project is viable or not. If any deviation is definitely going to give you a problem. So monitoring of CapEx and OpEx plays a very important role for profitability of the industry. Now, is applicable not only for a greenfield project, but also for expansion, modernization, and rehabilitation projects. So this is also one of the, to be considered as a technological requirement for every manager. Now, conclusion. We have a lot of challenges in front of us to make our projects successful. One is consistency policy of government, that is very important. Then cane price acceptable to farmers and mill owners. Then competitive sugar price to get our profit. And competitive ethanol price and sustainable power tariff. So, and also diversification of our byproducts apart from sugar, like bagasse, filter cake, molasses, in more potential route to support for making the sugar industry as a complex to its profitability. So this is one of the challenges in front of us. Each and every diversification to convert our byproducts in a profitable way in addition to sugar. That's going to be a long way to go. And everybody will put our mind toward this direction to make our industry more sustainable, more profitable. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Singh Sundaram. Time given was 45 minutes, but he has taken 46 minutes. Okay, anyway, well, very nicely. excellent integrated diversification of models. Before any clarification from the delegates, I would like to add a few words. Now, especially in South India, the sugar industry situation is very bad. I think it is worst, instead of saying bad, because of nature calamities, rain and all that. And also, there are so many number of sugar factories, 15 kilometers each, one chimney is there, sugar factory. And also high capacities, including my sugar plant. So with all this vertical growth of industry, including cogen is coming in the first world, whereas the cane is only horizontal growth. Because we can't grow the sugar cane in the first world, I think that may also come in future. Anyway, it is an imbalance between the sugar cane production as well as the capacity of the sugar plant. Anyway, it's left to the owners of the sugar plant. With all this imbalancing, even instead of earlier 9-month season, 3 months off season, now it has become 3 months season and 9 months off season. So that also is a main cause for the employment, paying salaries and interest paying for 9 months and working for 3 months. That also is heavy load. With all this, last year also same situation, this year also in South Karnataka, especially South Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. With this, I think it will be very difficult. In future, if it goes another 1 year like this, I think most of the people will become off-seasonal workers, seasonal engineers, seasonal chemists. Even the owner may also become a seasonal, I think. He may go to some other industry. This will become a seasonal industry. One more will have a textile, something like that, we will have a problem with this thing. So, in addition to that, I would like to one point in this. He mentioned the jaggery. I think it is getting a most popularity, especially this organic jaggery. In addition, his diversification of this primary juice is about 20%, something like that. Instead of what we are thinking now, plant at Murol, one small mill, 30 by 60 is there, so independent this thing. Put an organic cane in that, crush in that, about 55 mill extraction in that single mill. Divert that bagasse to regular mill, and that juice you make an organic jaggery. This you are planning this coming season. So the organic jaggery, now I think you may be knowing, it is ranging from 80 rupees per kg to 120 rupees per kg. And export also is having a good price. So that also I am thinking. So with this, I request the delegates to have some clarifications, actions or any questions to him.
Organic jaggery starts from the field. First of all, you have to grow the cane organically without any chemicals. So that care has to be taken care of. And unless you do that one, you cannot export this one because and the world, this one authority, they will not accept it. So, but definitely, as he says, it's having a very good price, 80 to 100 rupees.
Then in that Hubli and Dharavata, two mini sugar mills, jaggery, organic, they have started now, last season one and this season is going to be. The export rate is about 102 rupees he is getting. He is doing it near that MQ Hubli, that plant is going to.
One or two plants are
there. In Mughal also on that mini plant, I think JPM also has given a DPR that is going to come by next year. So with this, I request the delegates to have any clarification, additions and questions, if any. Yes, sir.
Good morning, sir. This is A.K. Malik from Haryana, Technical Advisor. Sir, we have the license to produce the sugar in a sugar factory. Whether any change is required to produce jaggery in cane control act, sir?
Sir, this is still a question mark. It is not clear, really not clear, but people are now trying to get an this one. See, the problem is how to fix the price of a cane. When you are diverting to cane, sugar, as well as jaggery, it is not having excess. Jaggery is not having excess. sugar is having your cell. So this type of complications are there, but some people are more, you know, hopefully they will come out with the solutions.
I must compliment Mr. Sundaram for the excellent presentation. Having said that, the integrated sewer complex, as per the concept of Mr. J.P. Mukherji, way back in the early 50s, was to have a sewer factory as an engine of growth for that particular region. He had a dream of setting up a sugar factory which is self-sustaining, which generates power, which also generates raw material for downstream industries. He even contemplated mini MIDCs, which will get the power from sugar factories, steam from the sugar factories for the textile mills. So that is one direction of the concept of integrated sugar mills. Second is what is indicated in today's deliberation. I personally believe that some of these diversifications which are being proposed as a part of integrated sugar complex are currently being practiced in one way or the other. And each one of them is fraught with a lot of uncertainties. Like Mrs. Patti yesterday said, 95% of the sugar factory operation is beyond our realm of the people. It is some policymaker or some such. What is that 5% which we can improve on? To me, it appears that the only way forward is cellulosic ethanol. Because the requirement of energy is unending. The availability of fossil fuel is finite. They are expected to be financed maybe 2040 or thereabout. Availability of biomass in the form of cane is also perpetual, reasonable, subject to improvement in the yield and water management and all that kind of thing. We talk in terms of higher cost. We talked of 10 years back, the cost of solar energy also some 17 rupees per kilowatt. Today it has come down to less than 5 rupees. Possibly the cost of enzymes used in cellulosic ethanol may also come down in the future period. Maybe focus can be in that direction, that's my submission.
And if you, this enzyme which is used for cellulosic ethanol, it plays a very important role, the price of that enzyme, which will dictate our conversion cost. So, but as of today, it is still a big question mark, it is not viable. But definitely, cellulosic ethanol is one of the future solutions for diversification of this.
Mrs. Bokhari from Global Monitor. Sir, you have mentioned here that the recovery during refined sugar will be lower than the partisan white sugar. But there is a third quality of sugar that is normally called as sulfurly sugar, where the ion exchange process is not stopped. In that case, it's edification, then raw sugar manufacture, then metal clarification, and the crystallization. So, in this case also, what will be the recovery effect compared to the plantation? Means sulfurous sugar versus plantation
sugar. Even then also, we have worked out this one. Slight decrease in the recovery is there, but it is negligible actually. So, that is also worth considering. See, what are ultimately this exercise is, what is the price you are going to get it obtained ultimately, and what is your profit level? That is what you have to work out. But options are different. Even why Mr. Mukherji told the long, long back, the whole world, either producing either raw sugar or refined sugar. Only India and one of few countries only plantation of sugar with fermentation process, importing sulfur and doing it. So, there is a market for raw sugar also. Export market is available. But anything produce raw sugar or this one, whatever the price you are getting it, to compare our cane price, are we in the profitable rate or not? That is what you have to consider.
Because while working out the profitability, cane price in case of refined sugar was considered low.
Yeah.
So it may not be accepted by the farmers. So if we go for the sulfurless sugar, I think in that case the cane price in both cases, plantation and white, and the sulfurless sugar will be same.
No,
it will be acceptable by the farmers.
No, the cane price, you see, depending on the recovery, it is going to change. If I recovery, the price is different, low recovery is different. So the cane price is, see, you have made a question of your CN. Why some of the costs increase, the operating costs, because the cane price has the respect recovery. So that you have to take into consideration.
But now the sharing formula also is
coming.
Huh? The revenue sharing formula also is coming. So the recovery affected the cane price also may not be made.
Okay.
Yes, so there was a time when everybody was saying go for expansion, go for cogen and everything. And every people is no offer that. Now the time has come where to use bagasse. You have gone for cogen, you have gone for expansion, as Mr. Chairman has said. Now for that, this problem, bagasse problem, what I feel, my suggestion, what Mr. Gangavati has said, it's okay. The other is that ISMA, Federation, Association, and other organizations should come to government, central government, others, and sit together to find the solution. When the government is purchasing power from fossil generations, why not from biomass? We are encouraging biomass instead of fossil. Then we should go for the biomass power to, as we are having cogen, to purchase by the government instead of purchasing fossil power. Although solar energy has increased and quantum has increased and they are purchasing from there, now with this, sugar industry shall again go to that sickness. So my feeling is, and my suggestion is, that all these organizations should approach the government and they should sit together how this solution can be worked out and how this industry can further, it can be sustaining in the line, not about sickness. This is my personal feelings and suggestion.
You have my conclusion is the same thing. The government policies to support our industry is definitely required.
Anup Kesavan, good morning to everyone. I'm from Chemical Systems. See, the point raised by Bhadia sir, that bagasse is a problem, going to be a problem. I assure him that this will not be a problem. Chemical system is already working on it, and with the association with Shell, we are working on bagasse directly to petrol. Not ethanol, it's directly to petrol. And the plant, pilot plant is just established in Mangal. And very shortly, you will be getting good news. And we are also working on the process which will be giving you direct refined sugar without raw sugar step. And the steam consumption what we are talking is around 10-15% only. And the sugar loss, I have been telling that we will bring it below 1 or 1.2. So that is our aim, and very shortly you will be getting all these news for the sugar industry, so that you can pay double what our Modi ji is wanting. You will pay double price to the farmers. Thank you very much.
My advance wishes to Mr. Anup Keswani. If you develop such one, definitely gives a good benefit for industry.
Thank you very much for the nice presentation, Mr. Sundaram. I am Jasveer Singh, Technical Advisor from National Federation. My simple question or suggestion is, what will be the fate of cogeneration in the future? Because solar power is coming as cheaper as 2.6 rupees per kilowatt. And why not? We should, in sugar industry, restrict our power generation to back pressure room only. The steam which is required for the boiling purposes, only that is to be converted into the power generation, and remaining bagasse should be saved as much as bagasse should be saved. And secondly, Bagar should be must kept in the category of biomass region. MNRE has kept biomass separate and the bagasse generation separate. The tariff for them is separate, for bagasse is separate. Tariff for biomass is higher, then the tariff for bagasse is less. Both these schemes are biomass, they should be kept in the same category and should get the same tariff. And my question is, when going through the back pressure route, we will soon save as possible, as whose saving of bagasse as possible, so that bagasse could be utilized for other purposes, as Mr. Chemical industry people are saying, and we should divert to the pulp, paper, furniture making and other making, because their biomass is very compulsive. But I would like to know your views, what will be the fate of cogeneration in view of the reducing tariff and the wind power and solar power coming very big way in the industry?
See, as I told you, cogeneration still today is not viable because of the tariff one. Once the tariff is there, still the project is viable. But I welcome the suggestion, definitely, in absence of cogeneration, what are the alternative routes for bagasse? Everybody has to see there is ethanol route, now in Sairam, this is a bag petrol route. Yes, that's separate one new port. Well, it should be separated out to bagasse without condensing turbine, only backward turbine, and save bagasse, and try to replace even pelletized the bagasse and use for some other as a fuel. All routes has to be evaluated, and it is applicable for us. That is the only thing we have to do. It is only an awareness of the present conditions, and accordingly, what is beneficial for us, we have to consider. Appreciate your views.
Sir, I have a question for E&D. While making organic agri, what do you use for clarification? No people use hydros. Instead of hydros, what is used?
No, in organic agri, the normal clarification is of lady's finger stem you are using, but no chemicals are used. There are some other plant solutions available which are used for your settling house.
Okay, so compared to open plant boiling, what do you think about
closed plant
boiling,
vacuum boiling? Vacuum plant boiling also can be done, but what will happen? The consistency of the mass flow you are going to drop is of a different nature as compared to our system. So open plant boiling is always better, and the excess roots, etc. is also placed in the first one. That is why vacuum boiling is not adopted in landing
boiling.
Sir,
our final point. How does this technology power to gas? Since hydrogen is going to be the future fuel, there are technologies available where you can convert the electricity into hydrogen. We did some working. 52 kilowatt of power will give 1 kg of hydrogen. And 1 kg of hydrogen costs about 1,000 rupees. We can work out the economics for future.
Sorry, I not know information, much of information, so I can't answer.
We should work with IOC.
And, okay. I heard about that, but I have not gone through.
Yes. So anybody?
Mr. Sundaram, good morning. This is Mr. Sugi from Dharmia Sugar.
Yeah.
First of all, I hope Mr. Rook is already wise, all my surplus with us. I'll be very happy to sell it to him at 3,000 rupees a ton. Second, in your presentation, you mentioned one data point on 2G ethanol. You were saying that the factories which have done it are getting about 110 to 125 liters per ton of wet bagasse.
Yeah.
Now, if this is a number and which has been replicated, probably, it will be an economical number. I don't know. Would you have more data on this?
These figures are not declared officially, I believe. Officially, still they are hesitant to declare. But what the information I gathered from other sources, it is in the range of in that one actually. But till there are so many question marks are there which need to be answered. So let us not disagree, let us hope. But definitely, the route is a better route. Still, some developments are going on, and we sincerely hope. The project may be very successful for the future generations.
It will be a good numbers.
Yeah, it's a good number, sir.
Thank you. So, anyone question last? Mike,
can you go to the mic, please?
Yeah. Morning, I'm Ramalingam from Dharamishi. Support Director for Sustainability and Sugar Industry Mission, Direct 20-23% operation. We are used to tracking. But you will think that we have so much of market in India, but I mean, I hope that most of the jagging is going for the initial registration, not for the consumption of but 5,000 tons sugar plant, 20% is around 1,000 tons. Like that, when we have so much of capacity of sugar plant in India, when everyone started diverting into jaggery, you will have such a market. Have you studied anything on that?
Sir, there is a good market, export market is available for them in addition to the local consumption. So you have to explore the market study and your point is very good. Everybody start making jaggery, there will be no market for jaggery. Okay,
I reply this question. Yeah. See, the jaggery production in India is very inefficient. We should discourage those jaggery production and divert these things to sugar industry. So that sugar industry can produce jaggery in a more efficient manner and the use of byproducts of bagasse can be better utilized. The extraction in the sugar mill is much better than jaggery production. So we should discourage and divert this jaggery to the market by stopping those inefficient jaggery.
Yeah.
I think market is the same. We do not want to change the market size. It should be the same. But we should divert those jaggeries to sugar industry for better efficiency.
That's right. See, that is one portion is to meet the existing demand as it is and divert this one. Then other one is to increase the jaggery production, then you have to see the market also. That's both are possible. What Mr. Ramalingam told is, if, okay, I have completed this, the present demand I have diverted and producing through the sugar factory, but some other factory produce some of this one, then the production is increased, then there is a market for it. That's what is question. Yes, this point is also correct. But Mr. Ramalingam, there are, see, go to Colombia. They are also producing jaggery, and most of the jaggeries are exporting it. And we have, in our one of our projects, we are also working out, there is an export market. But we have to catch it. We have to catch the export market. And the powder jaggeries which are being produced, is the free-flowing powder jaggeries are being produced, and which is having a very good market. And also, our Ayurvedic industry, Ayurvedic medicines industry, they prefer organic jaggery than anything else. They are really having a good market for it. Anyway, this market study also is required. But these are the options in front of us which need to be considered for making our complex right.
Dr. Dani from VSI. Yeah. Our observation is when we increase the meal extraction, the quality of jaggery is not good. After certain, after 90% extraction, we increase extraction. The quality affects the quality of jaggery. That is also a point to consider.
Yeah.
It is the total meeting. Mixed juice, you said.
No, we are telling only primary extraction. We are not making mixed juice. Okay? So only primary one. Yes, some extent it is affected, but that again the cane quality, see in the jaggery, the cane quality also plays very important role. You have to take that into consideration also. But this diversification of the primary juice is not much going to much affected because some factories jaggery produce over 300 TCD plant and 500 TCD plant in a normal filling tank. The only primary juice is taken. It was a good primary extraction and jaggery quality is not affected.
Okay. Then what he said is independent jaggery industry. I think it is a criminal because only 55-60% extraction remaining is going to bagasse and mangal. So it is a criminal. So the jaggery industry, sugar industry, that what I mentioned initially, take a juice and then bagasse send it to the usual mill. So the 95% extraction is completed. So that way is better. So I would like to add one more point what Mr. Bhatia also said, Gangavati also said. Whatever we discuss, whatever we do in this, the statutory bodies convey our views and ideas to the government policy conversion. I think that's taking a lot of time. As he said, how to divert this jaggery to sugar excise and all that, formalities and all that. I think that has to be encouraged. I think some strategic part like VSI and NSI, somebody should take lead. And also that what he mentioned, that cogen tariff also. The bagasse quality remains same, bagasse remains same, whole India and all that almost the same. And tariff from Karnataka is different, Tamil Nadu is different, UP is different. Why the bagasse quality remains same, bagasse quantity remains same? Only tariff is changing from all that. I feel some sector institutions should say that the tariff in all these states should be equal, just like GST. I think it has to be done now. 5 years is about 2 rupees there, 5 rupees, Maharashtra is 550, Karnataka is 380. And also in Karnataka, 1960 before Cogen is 2 rupees 80 paisa, now is 5 rupees. What was this? I think better we should move the matter to the government that just like a GST, general, okay.
If that is done, you have a problem of everything being fixed as 2 rupees 50 paisa.
See, in that case, your case, okay, in some of the plan states they are getting 250. Sir, the time is there now. I given only 8 papers by 1 o'clock. I think it is an interesting one. Handle one question with you and then do it, okay? Sir, any more question? Last one. See, if it is a good subject, okay, better discuss. And the presentation less and discussion more. I believe in this. Instead of showing all that, we will cut down the timing in the remaining articles. Any one question last?
Sir, myself Deepak Khandelwal from STAI Engineering. One my question is there, Institute of Organic Jaggery, making a grain growing through organic methods and making jaggery, which shall improve the actually conventional making jaggery process, so that we can reduce the cost of production of jaggery. We can also work it out on that area, so we can get a good quality of jaggery instead of low rates, which easily consumed by human beings in India.
Yeah, that's right. See, organic jaggery is having its own problem, but it's having a good price. You have to compare with your profitability. Which one is giving you a good profit and which is having a good market? Depending on your selected.
Okay, sir. Thank you.